So today I'm going to be doing my January favorites. I feel like this video is kind of really late, so I apologize. I've just kind of been in a rut with filming. I'm not sure what my deal is, but I'm gonna try to be better. I don't know. I think I'm just kind of in a rut in life, but I'm gonna still film, don't you guys worry. But I figured, better late than never, right? So I kind of don't have that many favorites this month, but next month I swear I'll have a lot more, hopefully, fingers crossed, because I've been trying out a lot of new products. So hopefully I like them and I can share them with you. And I have two first impressions coming soon on a mascara and a BB cream. So let's, get excited about that. But let's jump into my makeup favorites, starting with makeup. Anyways, the first thing is a concealer, because I have not been getting very much sleep lately. I've been trying to wake up earlier, so I'm trying to train my body to go to bed earlier and wake up earlier. Hasn't been working that well. I've been waking up earlier, but not sleeping all that much. So Benefits Erase Paste has saved my life a little bit. This is the number 2 medium. It's just a really thick pink, like salmon-y color, undertoned concealer that's great for under the eyes to make them look a little bit brighter and help me look more awake when I'm really not. So yay for that. I've really been loving that. I still use my L'Oreal CC Eye Lift Rollerball thing as a base. I just always use that. Then I put over my foundation. Then I put that if I need any little bit more just directly on my dark circles. I've been setting that though. I do need to set my under eye concealer if I use an actual like concealer and not just my CC Rollerball thing. And I love using this powder in the bottom of this Laura Mercier. This is the Laura Mercier Undercover Pot in 3. But the powder underneath is the Loose Setting Powder. It's amazing. It's just a very finely milled powder, and it almost has like a yellowy tinge to it. It's so amazing, you guys. It literally sets and doesn't look cakey or, I don't know, it's just, it's really good. It helps for my makeup, my mascara, like transferring down onto my under eyes, so this stuff's amazing. I tried to buy the powder in the full size, but it's not the same, so yeah. I also love the concealers too. I use the heck out of those. I just haven't used them in a while, but this creamy concealer is a lot like the, well, they both kind of look, oh, this one's the hard one, this one's the creamy one, is a lot like the Benefit Erase Paste, just not as pigmented, but still really, really good concealer. Moving on to foundations, I did a first impression on this month, and it's the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Foundation. I will link my first impression down below, but I love this stuff, you guys. Like, literally loved it. Probably wore it on my face for, I don't know, I'd say 15 to 20 days out of the 30 days this month. Was there 31 days this month? There was 31. Regardless, I absolutely love this foundation. It's very, very long-wearing and very natural-looking on the skin. I love it. So totally, totally recommend this if you're matte girls or you're oily girls. I don't think it's like matte all day by any means, but it helped me stay a little more matte and it didn't dry out my skin, which is really, really nice. Another matte foundation that I tried out this month is the Bare Minerals Matte. I used to use this way back in the day, but then I kind of stopped and then I was like, why not try it again? So I got this in light. I was color matched at Sephora and I have been really liking this again. I will use it over like my lighter foundations or just as like an all over just for like a light coverage. It's not super full coverage for me. I don't know how to build it up to full coverage or if I even want it that way. But for me, just like as a light wash all over the face or over top of a really light foundation, that works amazingly. Last little, oh no, not last little makeup-y product, but last face product is a blush. I fell in love, back in love with this e.l.f. blush. This is probably my favorite blush of all time, I dare say. It's in Pink Passion. It looks crazy, but on the skin, it just looks so fresh. Whenever I'm wearing this blush, people are like, you look very fresh today. I'm like, well, thank you. It's just sheared out, I don't know, it's matte, it's very chalky looking like when you're swatching it and like doesn't look pretty, but when it's on the skin, oh, it's just so beautiful. And it's like $3, you guys. I think you can even buy these at Target. So amazing blush. It's kind of gives me similar of effect of the Benefit Hervana, not the same, but kind of similar, that light pink fresh look. And then I wanted to mention a mascara that I've been wearing. I'm not sure if I mentioned this in my last favorites video, but I did do a first impression on it, so I will link that again down below, where I just reviewed and showed it on my lashes. But it's the Rimmel Wonder Lash, and this is a really nice mascara. It actually surprised me. It's not my favorite mascara, but I really, really like it. I still will reach for, this gives me a really lengthened, separated look, but if I want just like a bold, volumized look, I will go with my L'Oreal Carbon Black because that's like my go-to. But this is a right, nice, very, still statement sort of mascara, but still natural looking, if that makes sense. I don't know. It's a very, very pretty mascara on the lashes, and I really like it. It really lengthens and separates and defines, but I wouldn't recommend it if you have very sparse lashes because I notice a difference when I'm using my Rapid Lash and when I'm not using my Rapid Lash. Rapid Lash is like a growth serum for your eyes, for your eyelashes. Yeah, for your eyes. Crazy. So I notice a difference, like it looks the best when I'm consistently using that, and when I'm not, it doesn't look the greatest. They kind of just go wound, wound, wound. So definitely I would recommend it only if you have pretty decent lashes already. Sorry to all those not so great lashes, but try Rapid Lash. Totally try it. So those are all my makeup favorites. Let's move on to some random-y bits. I fell in love with this month. I fell in love with Victoria's Secret altogether. My dad gave me a gift card for Christmas, and I pretty much went crazy in there. I love their gym pants. I'm pretty sure I already mentioned them. I now own 3 or 4 pairs. They're heaven. They're amazing. They're a sweatpant. They're so expensive, but they're so amazing. I love them. And then I picked up this little baby. Oh, it smells so good. It's the Noir Tease, and I just got the body mist, the small one. I think this was like $15. I think it was on sale for $10, but it's such a great scent. It doesn't last all day, but it's nice to just kind of throw on. Since I work at Hollister and their scent is so strong anyways, I don't want anything crazy, but this is nice to just kind of throw on and just kind of feel fresh when you get out of the shower and it's not like spraying on a really expensive perfume. So I've been reaching for this a lot. It doesn't look like it that much, but that's just in this month. So yeah, loving it, loving it. Moving on to some shower goodies. I have 3 of those. I have a face scrub. I've realized that I really need to start exfoliating my face a lot more. That probably is my issue with clogged pores, especially using an oil as a face wash. These St. Ives Even and Bright Pink Lemon and Mandarin Orange scrub has been probably my favorite scrub that I've ever found. It's gentle but harsh at the same time, if that makes any sense. It's small granules and it's more of like a polish than a scrub. And it really just works for me. It's not too abrasive. I can use it every day if I want to, but I try to use it every other day just because I don't want my skin to freak out. But it's just a very gentle but good scrub. I've had it forever and I'm getting low on it now. If you have any recommendations for like a polishy scrub, let me know in the comments down below, because the original one is good, don't get me wrong, but I think it may be a little too harsh and the grains are so not togetherly spread. I don't know. This is like a polish. It's amazing. I love it. Try it if you've not tried it and you need a good exfoliator from your skin for the skin from the drugstore. Amazing. Some hair care I want to talk about really quick. I picked up this, I think, at the drugstore sometime last month. It's the 3-Minute Miracle Strong. I have not picked up this by Ozzy in so long. They came out with a bunch of different new versions of it. Basically, it's just a super thick, super moisturizing, hydrating conditioner. I hear mixed reviews about it, but I love it. It does good things to my hair, so yeah. And I think it's like $3. It's just a deep conditioning treatment. It's phenomenal. 3 minutes, throw it in your hair every once in a while when your hair is feeling like, not. Brings it back to life. So that's that. Then my last little showery goodie, this like lid won't stay on, but if you have a Trader Joe's, first of all, just go. You will love it. But this, Trader Joe's salt and lavender salt scrub is the best thing probably ever created, I dare say. It is an amazing body scrub. I think this was like $5 or $6 at Trader Joe's, and it smells like lavender. So I love using this at night because it, first of all, it just so smells so good. Lavender smells good to me. And it leaves an oil all over your body. So you literally don't need to put a lotion on after you're done with this. It can be a little crazy. I would not like use this before I deep or self-tanned or before I was going anywhere, because this does leave a very big film of oily, hydration-y goodness all over your body. But if you want to put that on and then put nice snuggly PJs on and go to bed, it's perfect. So that's what I do, and I've been literally addicted to that stuff. I can't even tell you enough. It's amazing. Amazing. So that is that. Last little randomy favorite. I have one random favorite and then I'll be done. Well, I have two. Let's talk about my addiction to Pretty Little Liars, shall we? It's serious. I think I've watched the entire season 4 times. Only because they took Desperate Housewives off Netflix and that is what I'm stuck with. I see all your guys' recommendations, but if you guys know the struggle of getting addicted to a new TV show, it's a commitment. And I just don't think I'm ready for that commitment yet. I sound like a wacko. But let's move on to another unhealthy love that I've had this month, and it is a Swiss Miss chocolate, hot chocolate mix, but it is the Marshmallow Madness. It comes with rainbow marshmallows in it, and I love it. I like using this with vanilla almond milk. It is like so good, it should be a sin. And it probably is not very good for me. But I love it, you guys. It is so freaking good. It's nice as like a treat after dinner. That sort of, you know, or I'll drink it in the morning, like before my busy day. Oh, it's just amazing. So I think I literally have 1 or 2 packets left. 2 packets. 2 out of 8? Yeah. 2 out of 8, I think. I think they came with 8. I don't know. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So I went a little cuckoo crazy and this is my second box, so. Anyways, don't judge. But besides that, you guys, I think those are all of my January favorites. I know it wasn't too crazy or too much, but I enjoyed my month of January. I hope you all did. We are headed into February, and I'm hoping that February is going to be a better month because, to be honest, January was good, but I hope February is better. So I love you guys. I will try to be more consistent with videos this month. I feel like I say that every month, but I'm gonna try. I have a couple of other videos planned. I wanna do some more girl talks because I feel like I've been getting out of the swing of that. Just because I have a lot of harsh comments of people being like, you do the same makeup look every day. And I'm like, I know, because it's me. And I have some empties that I need to start rolling out to you guys, an empties video. And then I eventually do really want to film a morning routine and a night routine. Those are just so hard for me to film, but I need like a whole day of just nothingness, and my days off are just filled with craziness. So that's that, you guys. Make sure that you're always checking out my vlog channel. It's always listed down below, and I like to film my life day to day. So if you don't get enough of me here on the beauty channel, go check me out on the vlog channel. I film pretty regularly, which reminds me I need to upload a vlog, but I'm a lot better at filming over there, and I think I film a lot more consistently over there than I do on here. So always check that out if you miss me, or follow me on Instagram. Again, always listed down below. I love you guys so much, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye, guys.